and parent should come and see this. This is like a wake-up call.
He just started his life, and he's gone, and he's never coming back.
Innocent lives cut short by murder.
We're losing too many men of color in this city.
But tonight, there's hope for the children of Philadelphia.
We're gonna knock on all the doors!
Hope from celebrities.
It's not fun to look at the faces and know that these people were shot, killed, murdered.
I'm gonna sing to the top of my voice about us saving our children.
Hope from witnesses who are stepping up and speaking out.
In this case, we had 8 people come forward right away. We could be announcing an arrest warrant being obtained or an arrest being made almost every day if witnesses came forward.
Hope from community leaders.
We have hometown terrorism.
Hope for the youth.
Not giving up on the children.
Tonight, making a safer city. New hope for a new year.
Philadelphia. It's a tragic way some are referring to the city of Philadelphia, stuck in a cycle of violence right now. And tonight, as part of our ongoing coverage, Making a Safer City, we introduce you to some young performers who hope Philadelphia will stop the killing. NBC10's Harry Harrison is live in the News Center with more on this story. Harry?
Tracy, in a city where there are already more murders than days into this new year, art is imitating the tragic reality of Philadelphia's violence. Some of what you're about to see appears graphic, but in this case, it is only an act.
They killed my baby!
It's not crime tape. It's caution tape. It's not real blood. It's paint. But the scenario is so real, Philadelphians don't even notice the absence of police or medics.
Do you know whose children are they? I need to know that.
This is a play.
And this is the opening act, a staged double murder scene to capture the attention of people in the neighborhood.
I was on a bus and I seen this and this has caught my attention like, wait a minute. It could be my son, it could be somebody's, my neighbor's kids, it could be my son's friends or something, so I just ran back.
After it was 2 dead bodies, after 2 dead bodies, I stopped, pulled over, and I noticed it was not real, so I thought it was real.
Oh,
The show was played at several locations in Philadelphia and surrounding areas, but the show's producer says he wants to take the play on the road to show people across the country that Philadelphia is not a city, but a state of mind. Harry Hairston, NBC 10 News.